Hello, future engineers, welcome to my YouTube channel. If you're still new to my channel and you like what I'm doing, please don't forget to subscribe and share my videos to your friends and to your friends' friends. That's the only way you can help me promote my channel and to keep me going, refreshed, and inspired. And I'm very willing to share my knowledge, especially topics in civil engineering, for your benefit. For the cantilever beam in the figure, determine the principal stresses at point A located just below the flange. Also, determine the maximum in-plane shear stress at point A. So here is the figure. So sigma x is my over I, so it is the effect of the 40 kN load will cause A to be in tension, and it is subjected to bending tensile stress only. The moment of inertia is 200 times 300 cube. So moment is 40 times 1 meter, 40 kN meter. So moment of inertia 200 times 300 cube over 12. Minus 180, because 200 minus 20 is 180, times 260 cube over 12. So the moment of inertia of the section with respect to the neutral axis is 186.36 times 10 to the 6 mm to the 4th. Substitute into the formula. Sigma x is 40 times 1000 square to make it newton mm. Y is half of 260, so 130 mm over I 186.36 times 10 to the 6. So normal stress at A is 27.9 megapascals. Normal stress Y is 0. And therefore, tau XY, the effect of the 40 kN load to point A, will cause negative shear. So tau XY is negative VQ over IB, where maximum shear is 40,000 newtons. Then moment of inertia of moment of area of the flange above A with respect to the neutral axis is 200 times 20, the distance of the centroid of the area of the flange from the neutral axis is 130 plus half of 20 is 140. So that's why you have 140 here. Over I, 186.36 times 10 to the 6, then B is the width of this section through A, which is the width of the web, 20 mm. So tau xy is negative 6.01 megapascals. Let's then plot sigma y comma sigma x comma negative 6.010, and let's imagine that its graduation here is 5 megapascals. So 27 would be somewhere here, and negative 6 would be here. Then sigma y is 0, comma positive 6.01 rather would be here. Then let's draw the Mohr circle. This is the first point plotted, so that's the x-axis, and this is the y-axis. But anyway, we'll just compute for the principal stresses. So this is half of 27.9, 13.95. This is R. And if sigma P2 is negative, then R would be the maximum in-plane shear stress also. So tau max, which is equal to R, is square root of 13.95 square plus 6.01 square. So tau max is equal to 15.19 megapascals. So sigma P1, sigma P2 is sigma bar, which is 13.95 plus minus R, 15.19. So sigma P1 use plus 29.14 megapascals tension, 13.95 minus 15.19 is sigma P2 negative, so it is compression, negative 1.24 or 1.24 megapascals compression. Then tau max is maximum in plane shear stress is 15.19 megapascals, because sigma P1 and sigma P2 have opposite signs. So therefore, tau max is just the diameter, radius rather, of this Mohr circle, which is 15.19 megapascals. So that's it for this problem. The plastic cylinder, which has a 250 mm inner diameter and a 262.5 mm outer diameter, is filled with oil. The cylinder is sealed at both ends by gaskets that are fastened in place by two rigid end blades held together by four bolts. After the oil has been pressurized to 1.4 megapascals, the bolts are tightened until each carries a tensile force of 35 kilonewtons. So determine the resulting maximum shear stress in the cylinder. So here is the situation. This is the plastic cylinder filled with oil, and the tension in the bolt, each bolt is 35,000. There are 35 kilonewtons. There are 4 bolts, of total tension would be 4 times 35 kilonewtons. Then this portion will be subjected to pressure, and we have a force that pushes it to the right, pressure times area. So this is the element on the plastic cylinder in that direction, sigma longitudinal, and this is circumferential direction. So P is pressure times area, 1.4 pressure. Area is pi over 4 times inner diameter square. So P that pushes the end gasket would be 68,722 newtons. Therefore, the longitudinal normal stress is PA, which causes tensile force, minus this 4 times 35,000 newtons, to be consistent, divided by area. So 68,722 minus 4 times 35,000 over area, pi over 4, outer diameter 262.5 square, minus inner diameter 250 square. So the longitudinal stress is equal to negative 14.17 megapascals. While the circumferential stress is PD over 2T, pressure 1.4, inner diameter 250 divided by 2, thickness is 6.25, where 6.25 is 262.5 minus 250 divided by 2. So I hope you can analyze that. So circumferential stress is 28 megapascals. So when we plot this, these are on the principal axis. Therefore, because sigma L and sigma C have opposite signs, the diameter of the Mohr circle is also twice the maximum shear stress in the cylinder. So 2 times tau max equals 28 minus negative 14 minus negative 14.17. So tau max can now be computed. It is equal to 21.08 megapascals.